Hello, boss babes and bosses out there. As you can see, we have a different background. Diba na-mention ko before na yung video natin maraming mga noises. Kasi merong nagko-construct sa front talaga ng bahay namin. So, ayun, I decided to check in na lang dito sa hotel na walking distance lang din naman sa amin. So, I asked my friend who's the manager here. Shout out to Madam Yurika Bungin. Thank you so much sa pag-reserve sa akin ng room dito. Like, kaninang umaga lang talaga, nag-message ako sa kanya kung meron bang available na room dito na merong window. The hotel is super nice and super cozy. So, kung andito kayo sa Vegas, you can go here, Avenue 1 Hotel. Sa Rojas Extension lang siya. So, in this video, I'm going to share with you the action steps that you can do to set your mind right, to set you up for success this 2022 as a freelancer. So, I know a lot of you guys still messaging me saying that hope this 2022 magkakaroon na ako ng client, yung mga ganun. You know what? Maybe you already have the skills that you need. Maybe you already have the portfolio that you can present to your client. But the right mindset, yun lang yung kulang para makakuha ka talaga ng client. If you want to become a freelancer, you also have the mindset that you need to easily get clients. So if you want to learn more, what are the action steps that you can do to have the right mindset to welcome clients this 2022, then keep on watching. So if you are an aspiring freelancer and you still don't have a client right now, I don't know kung saan phase ka, kung nasa phase ka bang na nagbibuild ka ng portfolio mo while you are still learning new skills. I don't know if you already, maybe you already have the portfolio or maybe you already have the skills. Or maybe you just don't know how to look for clients and how to negotiate with them, yung mga ganun. I don't know. I'm going to share with you the mindset that masasabi ko na sana na-realize ko to when nagsistart pa lang ako mag-freelance. Siguro hopefully makatulong to sa inyo para mas mapadali yung pagkuha niyo ng clients, para maging smooth yung transaction niyo if you do a project for them, yung mga ganun. So the first mindset that I want you to have this 2022 is to have a self-confidence, and you should believe in yourself that you can help your client. You can help them through the services that you offer to them. It's really hard to convince a client. I think I've already mentioned this one sa video na to. And I've mentioned there that you should have a self-confidence first for you to be able to easily convince client to work with you. Mas madali kang makakakuha or makakaland ng project if mismo ikaw believe ka sa sarili mo at alam mong matutulungan mo talaga sila at alam mo yung ginagawa mo. So, there are two actionable steps that I can share with you to build that self-confidence for yourself and to even believe in your services and products na in-offer mo kay client. So first thing is to learn. So good thing you are already watching this kind of videos here. Therefore, you are already researching the things na gusto mong ma-learn. That's very important part na magkaroon ka ng self-confidence. The knowing part. So the second part is the doing part. Now, after learning, after mo ma-research yung mga need mo ma-research, after mo malaman yung mga need mo malaman, now, I would highly suggest that you get a real client para doon mo ma-apply yung mga na-learn mo. The application kasi is the vital part talaga para mas magkaroon ka ng self-confidence. For those who don't know what are the test clients, ito sila yung mga clients na maybe family mo lang or family friend or maybe my friend ka na may business, tapos mag-a-ask ka lang if you can help grow their business through online or and kahit ano yung service na pwede mong ma-offer sa kanya. Maybe you are a social media manager, maybe you can ask them if you can handle their social media accounts para mag-promote sa service or products nila. Or pwede din graphic designer ka or website developer or video editor, yung mga ganun, yung mga prospect clients mo na feeling mo may maitutulong ka sa kanila. So, you can ask for a discounted rate muna just to get their feedback. Okay ba yung work mo or hindi? You can ask for their recommendations as well. And then, at the same time, you can also build your portfolio na pwede mo nang isend sa totoo mo talagang clients. Yung makakapag-bill ka na ng tama or yung right price mo na. So now, if you are thinking na wala naman akong friends, way na may business, Wala din akong family friends. Wala din kaming family friends na may business. Wala din sa family namin na may business. So, if ever walang-wala talaga dyan sa mga sinabi ko, go na lang sa mga businesses, small businesses sa town nyo, and go there. Maybe meron silang Facebook page. You can message their Facebook page. Or maybe you can really go walk in sa business nila. Maybe may coffee shop dyan. Hanapin nyo yung owner ng business. Huwag yung mga staff. Kasi they are not the decision maker sa business. Look for people na decision maker talaga. Kasi sila yung magde-decide if they want you to help them sa pag-grow ng business nila or hindi. So, or maybe if wala doon yung owner, you can just get maybe their phone number or just maybe you can write a note or you can write a letter. Tapos ibigay sa owner yung ganun. Actually, there are really a lot of ways on how to get mga task clients. You can also go to third-party platforms like Upwork, onlinejobs.ph, and yung mga super popular here in the Philippines, no? If you still don't have the list of third-party platforms, I will put a link below so you can message us there if you want to grab the list that we have, and then we will send it to you by a messenger. So for the second mindset that I want you to have this 2020 is to keep going even if you are not seeing any results yet. I know, I totally understand that it's really hard to keep going. Like, ang tagal mo nang nag-keep going, ginagawa mo naman ang lahat, nag-aaral ka always, nag-show up ka always sa social media, nag-pitch ka always sa mga prospect clients, but still, hindi talaga nako-close ang deal. So, meron talagang mga ganyan. I totally understand na it's really hard to keep going if you cannot see any results. Pa talaga, maybe meron na kayong client sometimes, but it's not yet stable. It's still hard for you to get the ideal clients that you want. I just want you to still keep going. Just keep going. Kahit feeling mo ang dami mong mga naging clients na nagiging heartbroken ka lang, just keep going. I know ha, iba-iba tayo ng journey, but I just want to share this with you. That in my 10 years, na-feel ko lang talaga na easy na lang mag-get ng clients mga around 3 years from freelancing ko na. But take note, sa 3 years na yan, ang dami ko pang nakukuha ng mga toxic na mga clients na dinadrop ko na lang. Like, super heartbroken ako yung feeling na gustong-gusto mo silang maka-work. Aside sa good yung pasahod nila, pero the attitude nila is like hindi ko talaga bet. Ayoko na yan. Nagkaka-stress, feel ako makakasakit ako nito eh. Yung mga ganun. Though, the client keeps coming sa akin, good yung flow ng clients. Pero, ang napansin ko, maraming mga toxic clients. So, I still just keep going. Kasi ang dami kong mga heartbreaks nun when it comes to clients. Always ako umiiyak sa mga toxic clients. Merong hindi pa ako nabayaran, yung mga ganun. After na mga 7 years, I think start lang like 7 years up until now. I'm really thankful, no? Pero siguro, I just decided na pag feeling ko hindi ko vibe ang client, hindi ko na siya tatanggapin. I don't care kahit wala akong client yung ganun. You just have to keep going and be patient with yourself. And sa ating mga freelancers, no, ang super goal talaga natin na dapat maka-work natin si client ng long term. Kasi once maka-work mo ang client na long term, that's already a win. That's already success for you. So, have self-discipline, show up every single day. I don't know what kind of productivity you think you have for yourself. Sometimes rust is a kind of productivity. That is an indirect way on how you can help your business by knowing when to rust. And meron ding kind of productivity na nakaka-move talaga ng needle. Maybe if you have a full-time job and you are still trying to get clients, maybe set at least 1 hour per day para gumawa ka ng something for your freelance business. I'm not sure kung ano yung gusto mong gawin. Maybe learn something new sa industry mo, or maybe apply mga remote jobs, or maybe pitch your services sa online clients. I don't know what kind of show up you are in today na kailangan mong gawin for yourself, but set aside at least 1 to 2 hours every day. I try to be consistent talaga with that one. Ako, full-time ko na kasi ang freelancing. Meron talaga akong mga sinusundan na need ko matapos for this client today, ano yung need ko matapos for my videos for today, yung mga ganun. Meron akong routine talaga na ginagawa ko sa journal ko when it comes to parang tracking my productivity every single day. I always list a to-do list na kailangan kong magawa for my personal life and for my work. If I'm being productive, even sa personal ko, or even sa professional or career life ko, I would put a star something, or parang good job Sui, yung parang note, yung ganun. It lifts me up, na, okay, let's do another productive day again naman for tomorrow. So, napaisip ako na baka makatulong din sa inyo to na strategy. We, Boss Up Fam, created a monthly Boss Up kit for us to track our productivity for our business or personal wise. So, itong kit na to, meron ka ng monthly desktop wallpaper, meron ka na ding monthly mobile wallpaper, and not just that, meron ding monthly Boss Up planner and monthly Boss Up check-in. So, ano itong mga to? Yung monthly planner natin is just parang calendar din siya view, and then you will put there kung ano yung schedule mo for that day, and then kung ano yung top priority mo for that day, and then you will put a star. You can edit that one sa Canva. I'm also doing that na ngayon digitally kasi ginagawa ko siya before sa journal ko, but since I want you guys to be productive din, masyashock kayo kung ano yung progress na mangyayari sa'yo in just 1 year. So, huwag niyong i-underestimate yung magagawa niyo for 1 year. Mag-twist talaga yung buhay niyo if you just choose to discipline yourself to do the things that you need to do every single day. Even if you don't like doing it, but you push yourself to do that, malayo ang mararating mo, boss. So if you want that monthly Boss Up productivity kit, then just message us down below so that we can do it monthly together. We can review our wins every month and always remind ourselves that we are doing great, we are doing better. The more you appreciate yourself, the more you are grateful for all the small wins and big wins that you have every single month, then mas ma-encourage ka pa to do more sa next month. So if you want that kit again, for 12 months, we are going to send you this monthly Boss Up kit. Message us below. Ilalagay ko ang link para mabigyan kayo ng full details about it and how to use it. I'm so excited to plan with you, to have a monthly review with you. If you do this, don't forget to tag us at BossUpPH and at Brixley. So the third mindset that I want you to have is 2020 is parang contradiction siya, but it's not a contradiction sa number 2 ko na sinabi. Kasi diba sa number 2 parang be productive, show up always, even if you don't want to do this, you have to have self-discipline to be productive. But the third one is to know that taking care of yourself is not selfish. It's really necessary for you to be able to take care of other people and of course to take care of your business. I cannot really emphasize this sobra-sobra, but you have to take care of yourself if you want to take care of other people. That's really true. The problem kasi, if we choose to take care of ourselves, parang nagiging selfish yung dating. Parang masasabi natin, ang selfish ko naman kung unahin ko na naman yung sarili ko. Especially those people talaga, yan yung naiisip nila. Especially if nasanay ka na ikaw ang always nag-take care sa ibang tao. So, yan yung parang naging mindset na ang hirap unahin yung sarili kung nasanay ka na inuuna mo na yung ibang tao. That is not good. It will affect your mental health. And basically, if your mental health is affected, it will also affect your emotional health and even the relationship with you, with other people, it will also affect that. So we don't want to do that to ourselves and we don't want to do that to other people. You cannot give something to other people kung mismo ikaw wala ka. Ano yung ibibigay mo kung wala ka naman, di ba? So you have to feel yourself first before you can feel other people. So the more na okay ka totally, like physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, then it's easier for you to take care the people that are around you. Kung isa ka sa mga tao na hindi masyadong inaalagaan ang sarili mo, this is the action step that I would suggest. that you do. First, take a time every single day, kahit 1 hour man lang yan, or 30 minutes, to do something for yourself. Maybe alone time. Yung parang, pare ako lang muna. Just 30 minutes, please. Yung ganon. And wala lang, alone time, just quiet time lang. Nagmumuni-muni, nagre-reflect. Or maybe nag-journal if mala-journal ka. Or kung hindi ka mala-journal, sige, magmumuni-muni ka dyan. Those are the kind of self-care na walang katumbas talaga. Like, it will really help you get in line again with yourself. Pag meron kang alone time, pag meron kang time to check in with yourself, check in with your surroundings, be present for yourself. Ang self-care kasi, for other people, parang magpunta ng spa, magpamasahe, that's also self-care, yeah? But it doesn't mean like yung mga ganun lang, like magpaayos ng buhok, manicure and pedicure, magbili ng mga mamahaling gamit, mga kung ano-ano yung mga binibili, yung iti-treat ang self sa coffee shop, yung mga ganun. That is a self-care, yes. Pero hindi lang doon nalilimit ang self-care. Pwede din doing uncomfortable things. Maybe also hindi ka mala-exercise na tao, pero you still a lot, at least 20 minutes to 30 minutes for workout. Like kahit mga light workout lang, cardio lang, stretching lang, that's already a good thing. So hopefully, the action steps that I have shared to you, mag-take action kayo nun, try nyo gawin din yun, so that you will have a right mindset this 2022. So before I'm going to end this video, I would like to flex the works of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out! So if you want to join our Facebook group, just research I'm Ready, it's Boss Up April Xui. And don't forget to like our Facebook page at Boss Up PH. And don't forget to follow us on our Instagram accounts at Brixui and at Boss Up PH. So yeah, hope to see you guys on my next one. Bye!